The AKS4100U utilizes a two-wire passive self-powered loop. We can utilize the label on the back here, which we see the positive and negative clearly indicated, which indicates which side of these push terminals is the positive and which one's the negative. We would use 14 to 30 volts DC on the positive side. And then the negative side would simply be our return signal, which is a non-powered 4 to 20 milliamp signal going back to your PLC or to your control device. So after you've wired up your AKS4100U, what you will see is it's reading distance up here in the top left hand corner, and you'll also see a flashing snowflake over here telling us basically that the device is active and it's currently reading whatever the level is that it's connected, you know, on the process connection that it's connected to. The programming can be done by removing the signal converter and the HMI display from the process connection. And simply, you can go through here and change what your output function is by using your up or down arrow. So right now we're reading distance, but say I wanted to read the actual liquid level from the bottom up, I could do that by switching it to level. I could look at what the output percentage is in a larger display. I could look at what my output in milliamps are. So right now it's 4 milliamps indicating 0%. And now I'm back to the distance here, telling us what the distance is from our reference point down to the liquid level surface. Here at the bottom also, you can see that there's a small bar graph with a percentage indicated in the bottom right hand corner. And that simply tells us what the percentage in the liquid level vessel is. So now once you're wired up and you're ready to actually program the device, you'll press the right arrow key three times. One, two, three. At this point, it's going to ask us if we want to enter the quick setup menu. Again, we're going to press the button under yes. At that point, we're going to indicate that the probe type is a single cable if we are using a cable type device. So we will hit the enter key for that. Now it's going to ask us what the probe length is. Now this is the total length of the cable inside the standpipe. So once we input that, we will use the right arrow key to actually highlight what digit we're trying to change, and then the up and down arrow to actually change said digit. Once we have that first digit set, we can continue to move by using the right arrow key to highlight the various numbers, and again, the up and down arrow keys to change those values. So once you have your length set properly, you're gonna hit the enter key, and then the next setting is gonna be the 4 milliamp scale. That's basically our 0%. These probes do have a bottom dead zone and a top dead zone associated with them simply because of the type of technology that it's utilizing. So here basically you'll use the tables found in the literature to reference the length of the probe and the conditions going on in the standpipe with the refrigerants, various refrigerants, to tell us exactly what our bottom dead zone is. So there we actually take our length of the cable probe and we subtract that bottom dead zone and end up with our 4 milliamp scale. So once we have set that appropriately, we will hit the enter key, and then the next setting is the 20 milliamp, which is our 100% mark. So it always has to be a minimum of 4.72 inches. That's the smallest top dead zone that you can obtain. However, if the top of your column extends up past the top of your tank, you could use a level and level over and then increase this so that your 100% does coincide with the very top of your vessel. Here I'm going to leave it set at the factory setting of 4.72, so I'll hit the enter. At this point, it's going to start a countdown, simply letting us know that the quick setup is going to be completed in 8 seconds. It counts down, and then once it hits zero, it comes back to the main menu, but we're still not quite done. At this point, we need to hit the enter key once more. That's going to bring us back to a store no. We want to change this value to store yes, so we will do that by using the up arrow or the down arrow key to change that to store yes. And once we've indicated store yes, we will hit the enter key once more, and now it's stored those settings, and the AKS4100U should now be reading your liquid level accurately.